Second World War. Over the next 7 decades and more, theirs would be a legendary union, and she would be his Ardhangini in the truest sense of the word. On the 14th of November, 1943, he became a father when son and the Birla Sahan, Aditya Vikram, was born. Later, he was blessed by daughters Jayashree and Manjushree. Ever watchful over his son's training, Basant would ensure that Aditya Vikram got the best education possible with an engineering degree from the Massachusetts Institute of Technology in the United States. When Aditya returned from the USA in 1964, Basant Kumar Birla handed over to him the reins of Hindustan Gas, along with an industrial license for a spinning mill. In 1967, Aditya Vikram became a father himself with the birth of Kumaramangalam Birla.
When I came back from the United States, my father gave to me an industrial license, a very precious commodity during those days, and told me to set up a textile mill all by myself with no help from the group. He had the vision, wisdom, and the guts to delegate responsibility. I must have made innumerable mistakes, but the training was worth all the mistakes that I had made.
When starting his career in business, Basant Kumar could have taken the easy way out. On the contrary, he took the tough road, spending nights on the factory floors and learning the nitty-gritty of business. Even though Basant Kumar rode the Indian industry like a colossus, generating wealth for the sake of consumption was never a priority for him. In his diary he writes, "We must have a simple mind. And again, it must be always in our control. We should keep our requirements at the minimum. Our personal expenses must be drastically reduced. And then we should try to develop our mind." Numbers and figures would speak to Basant Kumar directly and loudly, so much so that he would go on to fine-tune the Birla accounting system of the Partha to meet modern needs of industrialization.
Thank you.
In his long business career, Basant Kumar would create a huge empire, encompassing industries from cotton textiles to viscose rayon, nylon and polyester yarn, to cement and tea, tire, tire cord, paper, aviation, chemicals and transparent paper.
लाए हैं, करे जो कार्य न कोई वह करके दिखाए हैं, कई उद्योग बाबू आप भारत में लगाए हैं। गंगा के आंचल में जब तक सूर सहिता की धार बहे, तब तलक जिए बाबू अपने, जब तलक यह संसार रहे।
On the 23rd of August 1940, Basant Kumar Birla was made chairman of Kesaram Cotton Mills Limited. Under his stewardship, Kesaram Cotton Mills' fortune soared and ran neck to neck with his father's enormously successful business enterprise, Jiaji Rao Cotton Mills and Birla Cotton Mills. By 1945, Basant Kumar wanted to break new grounds. He set his sights on aviation and tea industries. He incorporated two companies, Bharat Airways and Jayashri Tea. The same year, Bharat Airways took flight. It acquired half a dozen Dakotas from the Allied Air Force and renovated them for commercial flights. The romance was cut short in 1953 when the Indian government nationalized civil aviation companies. Basant Kumar was certainly disappointed, but instead of mulling over the loss, he chose to move on and to look at other areas of growth. The only place where he expressed feelings was the pages of his diary. From midnight today, Bharat Airways will go out of our hands to government control. I am feeling very sad. In November 1956, the 25th Emperor of Ethiopia, Haile Selassie, visited India. At a meeting with His Excellency, Basant Kumar Birla shared his hopes to start a cotton mill in Ethiopia. In 1959, Indo-Ethiopian Textiles was set up. It was the first instance of an Indian company setting up an overseas joint venture. Pleased with the success of the venture, the Emperor awarded Basant Kumar Birla the highest honor of the country, the Menelik Second Medal. By 1967, Kesaram Cotton Mills' profitability was among the best in India. Within Kesaram, Basant Kumar started more ventures in rayon, transparent paper and cement, which diversified the group's businesses even further.
Thank you.
The Birla family's fortitude was tested in 1983 when Ghanshyam Das Birla, Basant's father, breathed his last. In 1986, a business division within the family proved essential, ensuring that it was done in a fair manner. Basant Kumar moved on to bigger projects. In 1986, Vasavdatta Cement was commissioned at Sedam in Karnataka. Later, he set up 6 cement units under Century Textiles and 1 unit under Mangalam Cement. The two companies, which brought substantial accolades to Basant Kumar Birla and his management skills, were Century Textiles and Century Enka. In 1990, Century Textiles was chosen as the finest mill in the world by Textile Horizon, an internationally circulated monthly magazine of the Textile Institute in Manchester. Foreseeing the changes that liberalization would bring to the Indian economy, Basant Kumar Birla embarked upon his next mega venture, Birla Tires, to manufacture automotive tires and tubes. Thank you. Basant Kumar has rarely shied away from being a hands-on leader. He took keen interest in all industrial processes, from raw material handling to inventory control to shop floor activities to quality control and logistics. He has been an ardent believer in the sustainable use of natural resources and preservation of nature. Basant Kumar ensured a green environment in all manufacturing facilities owned by his group. His concern extended beyond the factories to the residential complexes of his employees as well. A trait which sets him apart from the rest is his ability to spot talent. He hired the most diligent and brightest people. That he was proud of his human resources is obvious from his quote, "All my executives are excellent people. I don't have any complaints against any of them. They're very honest. They're very efficient. They're very sincere. They are part of the family." Basant Kumar Birla wanted to build more than just a group of companies. He dreamt of building national assets, which also included people.
That will be the biggest plant in India.
Yes, well, Vegas or not, but we are going to go ahead.
We must make it biggest.
Either we are going to be stagnant or we must go on.
We must keep on moving.
The Birla legacy entails an early initiation into business. Since the 1990s, Basant Kumar Birla's daughters too have followed in their father's footsteps. Elder daughter Jayashree Mota became a board member of Jayashree Tea and Industries Limited, while younger daughter Manjushree Khaitan was inducted in the board of Kesaram Industries Limited. Predictably, the sisters have also stepped into their parents' shoes, immersing themselves in social, educational and cultural causes.
You are my revered idol, my dearest father. I wish you, with all the sparkling, vibrant colors of spring, a very happy birthday.
The ultimate humanist that he is, Mr. Basant Kumar Birla has also felt that mental and moral improvement is impossible without proper education. Basant Kumar's singular dedication to put others before self also inspired his children to develop an unremitting commitment to their responsibilities. The conscientious need to pass on his vision and knowledge is also reflected in the Birla interest towards education. Basant Kumar Birla made his first foray into education when he was searching for a suitable play school for his son Aditya. Thus, Mahadevi Birla Shishu Vihar was conceived. Subsequently, more educational institutions were planned and perfected. One of the touchstones of Basant Kumar Birla's life has been the thoughtfulness displayed for all aspects of the world. This need to self-actualize is reflected in his diary, dated the 2nd of May 1940, where he writes, "Our bodies, mind, wealth, etc., dharohar of God. It belongs to God. He may at any moment demand it back. We should always be prepared for such emergencies. We should keep our bodies as regulated as possible." As the diary entry illustrates, Basant Kumar Birla was not a man given to indulgence, but some of the things that he freely indulged in all his life was his love for books, music and travel. Basant Kumar Birla learned to play the violin under the tutelage of Pandit Ramesh Thakur. Familial and spiritual events in the Birla household were generally accompanied by musical programs, often with the patriarch playing the harmonium. It is his love for culture and music which prompted Basant to set up Sangeet Kala Mandir. He also set up the Birla Academy of Art and Culture, both in Kolkata and Mumbai. The Sangeet Kala Mandir Trust has an auditorium in the city known as Kala Mandir.
And we hold about 75 functions a year, functions of dramas, Hindi, Bengali, English. Then we have got, you know, poetry, we call it the Kavi Sammelan, two functions a year of Kavi Sammelan, poets come. Then we have got music and dancing, and we have got functions of music, dancing, etc. Whenever we are in Calcutta, in case any function is there, we always attend that.
Basant Kumar's love for travel started with a chance visit to Rangoon, Malaysia, Java and Bali, which whetted his appetite for travel. In 1949, Basant Kumar and Sarla began a world tour from Egypt with their six-year-old son Aditya Vikram. But despite the lure of foreign lands, his heart lay at home. His favorite journeys were to the Char Dhams, among them Gangotri, Yamunotri, Kedarnath and Badrinath. Basant and Sarla Birla went on to make 17 treks to Kedarnath and 12 to Badrinath, both on foot. This commitment that they both shared to a spiritual realm would lead them to build some of the most exquisite temples around India.